Very good morning, good afternoon, and good evening, wherever you are, whatsoever different parts of the world. Green morning, green afternoon, and green evening. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the fourth program of ICSI, International Chamber for Service Industry, on 9th of August, Sunday. People say Sunday is a holiday. I believe, and we all believe, Sunday is more productive than other days. Why not to make best use of it? So wherever you are, either you're jogging, let's talk about and start the journey of the world early in the morning from Canada, Latin America, and United States. Whether you're on the East Coast or you're on the West Coast or you're in the central part, wherever you are, wishing you a great morning, early morning, wonderful morning, green morning. Please take care of your health, take care of your wellness, look after your friends, your family, your neighbors, your community. Everybody got to be fit. And I'm reminded over here something very interesting. When I meet Mr. Tim Grover in United States, who's Michael Jordan's coach, he says, we spend 99% time in the gym, basically working on our body. If we start spending some time on our mental faculty to make it robust, with the body, you got to be mentally strong. All the people, those are mentally strong, they will pass through the coronavirus without any difficulty, any problem. So you've got to be physically strong and you've got to be mentally strong. That is something very important. Ladies and gentlemen, let me move from Canada, United States, and Latin America to Europe. People enjoyed their wonderful lunch. Just hold on before you go for your coffee and your tea. We will be with you for a little while, short while. And we discuss a couple of new things with you. Because the micro, small, and medium enterprise world over is having lots of challenges during this coronavirus, during this pandemic. Okay, from Europe, let me come to Central Asia. Hearty welcome to all my brothers and sisters, those are joining us from particularly Uzbekistan, Kazakhstan, Turkmenistan, Kyrgyzstan, and of course in South Asia, when I'm moving to Bhutan, Nepal, Sri Lanka, Maldives, wherever you are, a very hearty welcome to you. People, those are joining us in India, namaskar, pranam, aaj ki sandhya, yane ke ravivar ki sandhya, 9 August ka, aap sabka bhavya swagat hai is karyakram mein. Ye MSME par hai, micro, small, medium enterprise, suksham, laghu, evam madhyam, udyog, in sab ko lekar, kyunki is samay, bahut sari mushkilon se gudar raha hai ye sector, aur hamare chamber ka, ये 84th प्रोग्राम है, 84वां प्रोग्राम आज की शाम इस लॉकडाउन में, इस कोरोना पीरियड में. नाउ मेकिंग एजुकेशन रेलेवेंट, हमने बेसिक थीम लिया है बिकॉज एजुकेशन इज रेलेवेंट फॉर एनी सेक्टर एनीवेयर वर्ल्ड ओवर. एंड इस समय, क्योंकि सबसे ज्यादा मुश्किल स्कूल्स, कॉलेजेस, इंस्टीट्यूशन, पॉलिटेक्निक, आईटीआईज, whatever we have got, skill development, competencies building, is sab jagahon par, as per the UNESCO report, if you see, 1.86 billion people are away from their schools and educational institution during this pandemic. So teachers are trying their level best, educators are trying their level best, technocrats are trying their level best. How can we reach out the youth wherever they are world over? Whether you are in the city or you are in the rural area, you are in semi-urban, urban, or you are in the far-flung areas, how to reach everybody. This evening, we are talking with all of you on MSME, how it can be empowered. We know there are lots of challenges, difficulties, problems, but well, every difficulty brings some new opportunities as well, we will talk about. From Central Asia, I'm taking you to Middle East. I'm grateful to people, those are joining from Doha, Qatar, Oman, Abu Dhabi, Sharjah, Dubai, and Kuwait. I'm so grateful to all of you because regularly you have been coming. Either you are on the webinar page or you are coming on the Zoom, but you're coming also on the Facebook. If you have got the Facebook, Dr. Gulshan Sharma's page, I would request you open your watch party. Let the entire humanity be benefited with the deliberations and discussions, whatsoever these legends are going to. Everyone is a warrior their own way. Like doctors, nurses, paramedical people, they are doing great service. Similar way, teachers are doing great service. Similar way, these celebrities, those are coming and those are sharing their thought processes to tell you how not to be negative and how to turn positive, how to take your agenda forward, how to restart, re-equip, re-energize yourself. All that, ladies and gentlemen, when we talk about this evening, we have got yet another very, very meaningful evening, what we are going to deliberate with all of you. Heartiest and deepest congratulations to Honorable Prime Minister of India, his entire cabinet, and the new education ministry, which was known as earlier Ministry of HRD and now Ministry of Education. School education, higher education, new agenda, new pedagogy, and vocationals, internship, skills, all going to be integral part of everything. Children getting their breakfast as well, lunch together, both at their respective places. Age limit increased when they were taking right to education. Now imagine how it has been and how the scope has been increased. And it has been rightly said that the mother tongue plays very important role. Mom, the mother, the ma, that plays such a good role. And my own native language, my own regional language, my own community language, and my home language plays a very important role. So initial grooming of the child when we are talking about school education. And day before yesterday, the Honorable Prime Minister addressed the entire country, India. And when he addressed, he talked about the higher education and all the stakeholders, 1,000 vice chancellors, directors, IITs, IIMs. And when you talk about the NCERT, NIPA, AIU, with them, the All India Council for Technical Education, University Grant Commission, and other stakeholders, they were together with the Ministry of Education now, and they were discussing and deliberating what is the new education policy, and the Prime Minister gave the roadmap that how serious the government is. So, Bharat se thoda sa aapko aage leke chalta hoon, because 650 million people join us from Myanmar, Cambodia, Laos, Singapore, Malaysia, Thailand, Indonesia, Philippines, Vietnam, and Brunei, all the 10 countries together. Great welcome to each one of you. And of course, our, you know, with our chamber, the lady who was working earlier and who is in Bahrain now, we are thankful to you and your husband and the entire community of 270 people from Bahrain you come. We are great, great salutations and regards to all of you. Coming a little further, people, those are dreaming about MSME, let them enjoy about it. Australia, New Zealand, and Fiji, because it's turning a little late over there in the evening. So from here, ladies and gentlemen, this is something wonderful which government is going to do. 6% of the GDP to be spent on education. Imagine what would be the outcome of, and what will be the progeny, and what would be the innovation, research, and this new breed which will come. And India being having the youngest population world over, imagine the youth, they are the future. These millennials have got wonderful ideas. Honorable Prime Minister's agenda that India has to become self-reliant, and this is the platform, and this is the base, and that is called the education. Making education relevant with your day-to-day life, making education in such a way that it has got 100% application as far as your life pedagogies are concerned. Ladies and gentlemen, our chamber since 1994 is such a wonderful journey. Initially in India, from 1994 to 2003, it used to be Punjabi Parvasi Divas. And from there in 2003, then the Honorable Prime Minister of India, late Shri Atal Bihari Vajpayee Ji, was kind enough and he gave the new thought process that with Punjabi Parvasi Divas, let's come out and work out with Bhartiya Parvasi Divas. And today when we look at, you've got vibrant Gujarat, vibrant Tamil Nadu, vibrant Rajasthan, vibrant Madhya Pradesh, vibrant Karnataka, vibrant Telangana, vibrant Andhra Pradesh. Everything is vibrant what is taking place over here. And more than 30 million non-resident Indians, those are abroad. Our chamber is a bridge between the non-resident Indians and India and the government. And I'm so grateful that we got an opportunity to work with the various ministries, and we have given a lot of roadmaps, white papers, action plans, and innovations, what all to be done. During this lockdown, we know Thought processes are affected. Businesses are affected. Physical and mental health is affected. And main part of the universe, that is education, is also deeply affected. And this is what the UNESCO conveys. And that is what I have discussed. But India always believes in the whole world, all of us together, wherever you are in the world, we are one family. It is a Vasudev Kutumbakam. That's what we talk about. One world, one love, one family, all of us together. Your happiness is our happiness. And our difficulties, we got to share with each other. And that is the way the whole world has to be together. We started this journey and the total focus is every day, that is Monday to Saturday. Monday to Friday, we talk purely on education at 7 p.m. Indian Standard Time. And Saturday, we talk about your health, wellness, yoga, meditation, naturopathy, Ayurveda, nutrition, positive thinking, anti-depression, anti-anxiety, anti-stress, and so many modules. Last evening, we had a wonderful session from the world over. So now there is a new journey. Earlier, we were working Monday to Saturday in the evening. But from today, the MSME takes a stage, the center stage, and Sunday evening, comparatively, people are a little free. We are going to share a lot of thought processes under the expertise and the vision. I will be sharing with you in a little while the gentleman who will be heading this particular mission and this particular task and this particular agenda. And we have taken totally as a selfless service because we want the MSME, which has suffered a maximum blow during this time, should be regained, re-empowered, re-energized. So that's why I was sharing with all the stakeholders on different platforms. When we sent across to you, wait, something nice is coming for all of us. Ladies and gentlemen, we started on 5th of June, the World Environment Day by the United Nations. And making education relevant, what it has got to do with the World Environment Day. All the research which we gathered from the world over, the next misunderstanding and the crisis and the difficulties are going to be on water sharing. It's going to be related to water conservation. It's going to be somebody can build a dam in their country where the rivers originate, and whenever they would feel like, they will choke it, and whenever they would feel like, they will open it. They can have the flood and they can have the drought. And at the same time, the drinking water. This afternoon, we had a session with number one gentleman who is for the wildlife and for the forest conservation, the principal chief conservator from the northeast part of India. He came and he shared the vision. And he says, Northeast India has got plenty of water, but when you talk about drinking water, there's a lot of shortage. So ladies and gentlemen, your kids are at present at home. Your small kiddies, your grown-up kiddies, everybody is at home at this point of time. Parents, can we make a humble request to you that let's save every drop of the water. Jal sanrakshan ki bahut jyada zarurat hai. Bachchon ko bataiye bathroom mein, kitchen mein, ghar mein, nahane mein, kisi bhi cheez mein. Pani ko kaise bachana hai? Har pooni pani ki boond jo hai keemti hai. Aur kal hum ek bahut bada session karne ja rahe hain 11:30 baje water management ke upar, that we are bringing tomorrow. Now, Saturday morning, every Saturday morning, 500 million plus people, followers of Buddhism world over. What is the relevance of Buddha's teaching in today's education? Because when we are talking about making education relevant, every stakeholder has got something to share with us. So we had yesterday morning, and we are trying to get from world over the expertise. We had the lady from Australia. We had the another lady from Singapore. And we had the gentleman from Indonesia, and they shared their global perspective. What is the relevance of Buddha's teaching in today's education? So next program is going to be on Bharat ke Swatantrata Divas wale din, 15 August ko morning mein, subah ke hamare mananiya Pradhan Mantri ji ke address ke baad, hum is program ko lekar chalenge. Saturday evening, Ayurveda for Global Wellness. I'm so happy. From world over, we are getting so many inputs. We started with Ministry of Ayush. The advisor to the Ministry of Ayush was first speaker, along with the director lady in Delhi, which is the National Institute for Ayurveda. Together, we started the journey, and we are coming in such a beautiful way I'm so grateful. I'm so happy. Every Saturday from world over, so many queries are pouring in. How can we be getting Ayurveda services? What is yoga, meditation, naturopathy? What is healthy eating? What is vegetarian food? What is vegan? All that is being discussed on this platform. So don't forget to join us every Saturday, 7 to 8 p.m. That is on Ayurveda. Now comes Sunday morning. Sunday got to be more productive than other days. As I was sharing with you, this is the fourth webinar. Can you imagine? We had the 81st webinar early in the morning, then 82nd, then 83rd, and this is the 84th. Now, what do we do on Sunday morning? We start our Sunday morning in a beautiful way. We talk about India's Upanishad. We talk about what are India's epics. What is India's ancient Granth? What is India's Ved? What all those Vedas they convey to us? And none other than a professor, Satendra Dhiman, who comes live from the Woodbury University, Burbank, from California every Sunday. And you will be surprised to know his program is from 9:30 to 11, but we are never able to finish before 11:30. So many queries, so many questions, so much dialogue, so much deliberations, and so much of, it's a, such a pious kind of a words, we get it. Do join us next Sunday, 9:30 in the morning. And today we have done, now we have done the closing of Srimad Bhagavad Gita, and now we are moving basically where the Jeevan Sanchalan Kaushal, the India's Upanishad, that we will be talking about. And then comes Sunday evening, 5 p.m., India, ASEAN together. Can you believe it? 650 million population. Our present president out of Thailand, he joins the program. Our past president from Singapore, Karan Singh Thakral, one of the richest NRIs over there. And Dato Ramesh Kodamalji, co-chairman of the ASEAN India Business Council, he's in this program now also, and he watches the last program and then he goes to sleep. So ladies and gentlemen, what I wish to share with all of you from today, the new journey what we are starting on MSME. Now, 12th of August is another very important day for ICSI. United Nations on Wednesday, 12th of August, it's a World Youth Day. We are getting, if I tell in English, 100,000. If I tell in Matrabhasha, 1 lakh Yuva Pidi ke log, 1 lakh bacche, hamare pure Bharat se is program mein jud rahe hain. Non-stop 12-hour program from morning 9 a.m. till 9 p.m. Celebrations, jubilation, congratulations, music therapy, gamification, all that is coming on 12th of August. And at the same time, I have sent across a request to a couple of people, and I'm pretty sure that they would be kind to join us. We are going to get Shivani ji, and she is going to talk about positive thinking, how to think positive. She would be joining us from Mount Abu. We sent a request to her. Now, when we talk about our chamber, the research which we have carried out from 25th of March till 31st of July, ladies and gentlemen, B2B, it will not be termed anymore for at least some time, business to business. It will be termed as back to basics of life. And during this particular pandemic, what we learned is, मैंने अपने घर में ऑर्गेनिक सब्जियां उगानी शुरू कर दी हैं और मैं वही सब्जियां खा रहा हूं और वही सब्जियां, क्योंकि जब ऑनरेबल प्राइम मिनिस्टर कहते हैं कि आत्मनिर्भर भारत बनना है तो वो कहां से बनेगा, कहीं ना कहीं तो शुरुआत करनी है, अपने घर की छत पर, अपने घर के प्रांगण में, आपके घर के किसी भी कोने में कोई भी जगह है वहां कोई ना कोई ऐसी सब्जी उगा लीजिए और उस ऑर्गेनिक सब्जी का आप स्वाद देखिए. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, agriculture and animal husbandry, when we talk about your basic survival, your basic food is very important for all of us. Second part, health and wellness. In that comes the happiness also. Jo log music enjoy karte hain, you will be surprised to know music ki jo notes hain, music se jo happiness aati hai. Aap gana na bhi gaate ho, gana suniye. It works as a lubricant in your body and it removes all the frictions, all the stress and everything. Try it out. मैं तो ढूंढ रहा हूं कि तानसेन ने वो कौन सा गाना गाया था, राग दीपक, और वो YouTube पे मेरे को मिला नहीं है अभी तक. I'm just trying to find out जिससे सारे दिए जल गए थे. तो म्यूजिक के नोट्स की तो बहुत पावर है, तो म्यूजिक को एंजॉय कीजिए इन दिनों में. और मैंने, इफ आई टॉक माई पर्सनल, आई रेड अबाउट नालंदा यूनिवर्सिटी क्वाइट अ बिट. आई वॉच्ड ऑलमोस्ट ऑल द वीडियोस. विश्व की, कैन यू इमेजिन, इंटरनेशनल रेजिडेंशियल फर्स्ट यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ द वर्ल्ड इन इंडिया, दैट इज कॉल्ड नालंदा. तक्षशिला रेजिडेंशियल नहीं थी, नालंदा वॉज रेजिडेंशियल. 10,000 यूथ, 2,000 टीचर्स, आचार्य आ रहे हैं, और जो दरबान है वो पहला इंटरव्यू ले रहे हैं. इमेजिन वॉट इट वॉज. सो when I'm talking about education and when we talk about Nalanda, all that, ladies and gentlemen, let's come to the third vertical, education golden triangle mein. Sabhi teacher gan, sabhi adhyapak gan, haath jod ke samr nivedan hai, aap sab logon ko vinamr nivedan hai, aur main ye kehna chahunga ki education ab January February wale mode mein nahi jayegi, ye ab aage jayegi. Jo kuch aapke paas 4 5 saal 6 saal ke baad aana tha wo aa gaya. Now the education is going to be digital. Technology is going to play a very important role. There's going to be an e-learning. There's going to be a flipped learning. There's going to be a blended learning. अब आप इसे जो मर्जी कहिए, चार दीवारी के बाहर एजुकेशन आ जाएगी और सब कुछ प्रैक्टिकल होगा. अब तो ऑनरेबल प्राइम मिनिस्टर ने और कस्तूरी रंगन जी की पूरी कमेटी ने जो सारा काम किया है, वोकेशनल भी आ गया, स्किल भी आ गया, कॉम्पिटेंस भी आ गया, पैशन भी आ गया. कोई साइंस नहीं, कोई कॉमर्स नहीं, कोई आर्ट्स नहीं. अरे साइंस वाला म्यूजिक भी ले सकता है, साइंस वाला फैशन डिजाइनिंग भी ले सकता है. इमेजिन व्हाट अ ब्लेंडिंग हैज बीन डन. सो लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, अर्न एंड लर्न का फॉर्मूला अब इंडिया में भी आएगा. दैट मींस ये नहीं है कि सिर्फ पढ़ते रहो जैसे विदेशों में होता है और बाहर के मुल्कों में, बाहर के देशों में होता है. हर एक बच्चे को पार्ट टाइम जॉब भी करना चाहिए और साथ में अपनी एजुकेशन भी लेनी चाहिए. But the entire model is on sustainable development, what we are talking about. This is the last slide before I introduce you my today's warriors and today's celebrities, because like it happens in the film industry, they say, ladies and gentlemen, the best award goes to best actor, best actresses. For me, these three golden triangle people, those are coming, they are celebrities, they are actors, they are performers, they are legends, they are visionary. Because they are going to give something to humanity. Our chamber feels and believes whatever human mind can conceive and believe it can achieve. At the age of 70, if I'm a vegetarian throughout my life, if I'm a teetotaler, and if I walk the planet and I've seen most of the countries, I've enjoyed the best of the destinations, I've enjoyed the best of hospitality, and after this webinar, I'll sleep like a log and I'll get up tomorrow morning at 3:30. If you maintain discipline in your life, you can feel as young as Major Dr. Gulshan Sharma is feeling. I'm 20 years only. My biological clock, I am not. That I have told Rabindranath ji, please don't talk about my biological clock. Just think about my mental clock. I'm 20 years old. So ladies and gentlemen, let's come together. Make education relevant. If you make education relevant, everything is going to be relevant in this universe, in this life. It's a global confluence of educators, motivators, technocrats, counselors, and corporate together. Our chamber extends you a very warm welcome. Should you wish to be a panelist or you want to send any suggestion, please send it innovation@icsi.asia. Should you wish to give a small WhatsApp, you're more than welcome to send it. So now comes the wonderful moment for which we were waiting, because this I just thought I should share all with you so that we are on the common frequency, because every day we have got some new people, those join this particular program, and they say, what is the purpose of this webinar? Why are you having this webinar? So I want to share. Ladies and gentlemen, let me extend a very, very warm welcome. Biologically, my younger brother, but intellectually, my elder brother, that is Shri Rabindranath ji, the former chairman and managing director, National Small Industries Corporation. A very hearty welcome to him. He gave me the inspiration. He gave me the encouragement. And when he held my hand, this 70-year young boy felt, why not to do something in the MSME sector together when we are doing so much for education, wellness, health, and everything together. So ladies and gentlemen, for the benefit of the entire global fraternity, those have joined us today, Shri Rabindranath ji served as a chairman and managing director of the National Small Industries Corporation, a public sector enterprise of Government of India, till September 2018. And during his time, I had been walking in and out of the corridors of the Ministry of MSME. And I had been going over there, meeting secretary, additional secretary, all the teams. And we gave the vision paper, action plan, roadmaps, and everything. And I'm so grateful that he was also there to share the vision with all of them. And I'm very happy that Madam Nirmala Sitaramanji, the other day when she announced and she told that the five different verticals which Honorable Prime Minister has empowered during this coronavirus, one of the vertical which is on the MSME sector, now the services sector and manufacture to be brought at par and to be given the due weightage. You can't imagine how much happiness it gives to a chamber when you put your baby steps and you give something, and maybe it took a little time, but finally it was acceptable. So ladies and gentlemen, besides this, Shri Nadji, he has held senior positions of corporate head of the finance in public and private sector. Shri Nadji has over 3 decades of experience in various areas of finance, accounts, and management. He has worked on various initiatives to achieve inclusive growth in the country and particularly in the MSME sector. Nothing could have been more fortunate for our chamber than he taking on the responsibility and helping us. He was actively engaged in promotion and development of MSMEs, as well as entrepreneurship development, creating collaborative environment to promote technology transfers, joint ventures between MSME both in India and overseas. And he will share with you what all during his time he brought. Last time we had one-to-one, heart-to-heart, and people enjoyed his session so much. Shri Rabindranath ji, he has been conferred with the several awards, including CMD of the Year Award in June 2015 for his exemplary role in promotion and development of the MSME sector in India, Outstanding Leadership Award conferred by the four and top rankers in 2018 for achieving business excellence through creativity, innovation, and entrepreneurship. So hearty welcome to Shri Rabindranath ji. He is a great visionary, and I'm so thankful to him that he accepted my humble request. Ladies and gentlemen, we have also been joined this evening by Shri Vidya Sagar Singh. He's a general manager, brand development or business development, and head digital services, NSIC, National Small Industries Corporation, which is a Government of India Mini Ratna enterprise under MSME Ministry, Government of India. More than 21 years of experience in the field of business development, e-commerce, global sourcing, and supply chain management with leading MNCs and Indian, the confluence the world over. In his current role with NSIC, he's heading the digital services department and working on the new digital initiatives for facilitating growth of Indian MSMEs. That's a great task because everything is getting digital. Before that, he has worked with We Are Pentagon, UK, Lifestyle, Aditya Birla Group, TPG Capital, and Li and Fung on top position. With his experiences and his vision of facilitating small-scale players to join the forefront of the top business lines, ladies and gentlemen, hearty welcome to Vidya Sagar Singh ji also, because he brings the corporate experience to the government now. So that's something really remarkable. We've also been joined this evening by Amrinder Singh Chahal ji, who is Amazon Global Selling Head. Shri Amrinder Singh ji is a part of Amazon's global selling program and has led Indian MSME seller onboarding across North America and Middle East markets. He's an alumni of the ISP Hyderabad. I recently visited them to give some talk, and has been with Amazon since inception of his global selling team in 2015. Ladies and gentlemen, what a pleasure to have these warriors and these celebrities and these amazing personalities this evening. They're going to share their vision. And with that, like it happens in the media entertainment industry, let me also have a privilege to extend a very warm welcome to these dignitaries and these celebrities to share their vision this evening with all of us. And I hand over to my technical and my experiential elder brother, Rabindranath ji, but biologically, I will still carry forward because I can't help it, sir. I came to the world a little before you. With these words, Rabindranath ji.
Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Wilson Sharma. It is always great to hear from you and it's so inspiring. It's a great task which you have taken and I'm there to share with you whatever experience I carry. Because MSMEs, we all know, is the backbone of every economy. And the topic which we have taken for today's webinar is leveraging e-commerce for the MSME's growth. But before I come to the topic, sir, I would like to extend a very warm welcome to all the participants from all over the world and my co-panelists, Mr. Amrinder Singh Chahal and Mr. Vidyasagar Singh, both of whom have very illustrious backgrounds, great experience, and I'm sure they would be doing a lot of input giving to the MSMEs who at the present juncture are perhaps feeling a bit low because of the effect of the pandemic, which is there, the impact it has made on the business and the economy in these days. Well, I am reminded of a story and I would like to narrate this story, which at least I had not heard, I had not read it till a little while back. And this story conveys a very great meaning. This story is the story of the bridge on the river Cholutka. It's a river in Honduras in Central America. And Honduras is a place where very often they have a lot of hurricanes and all that stuff. The bridges normally are being torn apart and this particular bridge was being given to the Japanese to build it. The Japanese, as they are known for the excellence which they always put in every task they do, they built this bridge which was 484 meter long bridge. They started building it in 1996. And it was thrown open to the public in 1998. It was a modern day marvel in terms of design and engineering and a pride and joy for Cholutka. Pardon my pronunciation of the word Cholutka because I have been hearing it in different ways at different places, but the story is more important. It was in October 1998 that Hurricane Mitch had hit Honduras. As a result, there was 75 inches of rain in 4 days, equivalent to the rain which they normally used to receive in 6 months. And as a result of this hurricane, all bridges in Honduras were destroyed, except one, the bridge, the new bridge on the river Cholutka. It had remained unaffected. But then there was a problem. While the bridge was intact, the road leading to it and the road leaving it were both swept away. And what was left was only the bridge. Further, what had happened was the flooding caused the river Cholutka to change course. It created a new channel. Now the river flowed not under, but beside the bridge. Just imagine a marvel of technology suddenly being kept aside and the river flows somewhere else. The bridge was strong enough to survive, sir, but it became a bridge over nothing and a bridge to nowhere. This was a story which had happened. This was a reality which had happened, not a story which it was a reality which happened 22 years ago. But the lesson from the bridge on the river Cholutka is more relevant today than at any other time. It's a terrific metaphor for what can happen to us, our careers, our businesses, our lives, as the world around us gets transformed. The message which this bridge gives is adapt to change or else. We are very often focused on creating the best solution to a given problem. We often forget that the problem itself might change. The need could vanish. The market could change. We tend to focus on the bridge, ignoring that the possibility that the river underneath could change course. We must need to think about that also, that the river might change course. We have been thinking about built to last. It has been a very popular mantra, but build to adapt could be the way to go. When we remember the story of the bridge on the river Chalutka, we often build a business, but we forget to learn to adapt to change. And we should not be ending up like the Chalutka Bridge, a superb bridge over nothing and to nowhere. So this story, even in today's times, we have everything. We have the best of businesses. We have the buildings, the factories, everything intact, but we don't know how to go about. And the world time and again has adapted to the new normal. It's not the first time that we have been hit by a pandemic. It's not the first time that we have been hit by something unusual. But then we have always tried to adapt to the new normal. Those who do it, they are there to take things forward. And that is what has been the thought process of our Honorable Prime Minister when he has been constantly bringing about concepts like Make in India, like Digital India, like Skill India, all aimed at the growth of SMEs in the country. Even the recent packages which were announced under Atmanirbhar Bharat, one of the things which comes to my mind is the government has announced e-market linkages for MSMEs. I'm drawing closer to the topic for today because MSMEs are something which is very dear to my heart and something which the economy always believes and feels every moment of our life. The package which talked about e-market linkages for MSMEs said that they will be promoted to act. E-market linkages will be promoted to act as a replacement for trade fairs and exhibitions. Ladies and gentlemen, we are very often hear about Indian MSMEs being talked about, that they are the backbone of the economy. They contribute to GDP, the falling percentage, they contribute to manufacture, they contribute to employment. And maybe we rattle off about 4 and 5 sentences and then suddenly there is a lull. My colleagues from the industry who are joined on this program would agree with me that there is always a feeling that probably there is something amiss. There are challenges in terms of finance, there are challenges in terms of marketing, there are challenges in terms of technology and various other support services which MSMEs always look forward to. But today when we have two experts with us, I would try and focus my subject to e-commerce, digital marketing, because that is what marketing is something which is being faced as a challenge by the MSMEs. The increasing global competitions, the complex cost structures, and the insistent quest for delivering high customer satisfaction is making the MSMEs almost necessitating the adoption of technology and innovation for bringing positive changes, which can drastically improve the way the small and mid-sized businesses operate, so as to enable them to sustain in the present scenario. This is where, and this is what is encouraging SMEs to adopt e-commerce as an innovative tool to build fresh business models. It's inculcating, effecting efficiency gains, changing the way they can interact with the global markets. We always look up to the entire world, and especially, sir, with the introduction which you gave, when the entire world is there, and I'm sure you would agree that every country you have mentioned, their backbone has been MSMEs. And one of the challenges which they always face is marketing. And I'm sure everybody looks up to now digital marketing, e-commerce, because it has features like the rating systems. It has features like the feedback mechanisms, the payment options and tools, the security and trust certificates, which enable the creation of an ecosystem which builds trust in the market immediately as compared to the years of efforts required by offline market. SMEs are beginning to realize, even those who are offline, that adopting e-commerce could cause more good than the perceived harm. You know, people are very reluctant to change to anything. हमारी दुकान है पुरानी दिल्ली में, थोक के व्यापार करते हैं. हमारी दुकान है फलानी जगह पर, हम ऐसे बिजनेस करते हैं. पुश्त दर पुश्त बदल जाती है इस तब्दीली लाने के लिए कि कुछ नया करें, कुछ नया सीखें. और वो नया अगर होगा तो सभी के लिए उचित होगा. एंड ऑलवेज पीपल लुक्ड अप टू डेटा, क्या ऐसा हुआ है. And that makes me, you know, refer to a report, a national report on e-commerce development in India. And I could lay my hands on the report of United Nations Industrial Development Organization in 2017, which said that 85% of the SMEs which adopted e-commerce believe that it is a cost-effective medium to grow sales. It says that they have witnessed 51% higher revenues and 49% more profit on an average. It also says that e-commerce enabled SMEs report 60 to 80% reduction in expenditure in distribution, marketing and sales to get incremental business. And 27% of the Indian SMEs who are online today use e-commerce. So this is enough evidence that change is the necessary imperative. Also, when we look at the common person, the person who doesn't have great background but has an aptitude to do something, to do some business, the ladies who may not have studied much, and we have vast examples world over that people may not have great academic qualifications, but they had the spirit to perform. And it has also been found that low entry barriers provisioned by the e-commerce, such as low setup costs, audience reach, work-life balance, better margins when compared to offline sales, all these have enabled even women to get financial independence. So all these today are basically and gradually making e-commerce being accepted as a good alternative and not being any longer a passing trend, but a reality that can no longer be ignored or contained. I would also take a minute more to mention that our Honorable Minister for MSME had said last year that government is planning to launch Bharat Craft. Our Honorable Minister last year had said that the government is planning to launch Bharat Craft, an e-commerce portal on the lines of Alibaba. And very soon we shall see turnover on the platform to the tune of 10 lakh crore in the next few years. This portal is to be jointly run by SBI and the government. You never know till at times it so happens that there is many a slip between the cup and the lip, but the government is determined. Who comes in as the best player and to join the government on this? And the potential which the Indian e-commerce sector has, it says that the projected business is expected to cross 300 billion by 2030. This potential is what is encouraging State Bank of India to invest about $100 to $150 million and leverage the Yono platform to set up a business-to-business e-commerce marketplace for the MSMEs. We would have recently heard Facebook having invested about 5.7 billion, or if I put it in INR, it is 43,574 crore rupees, with Reliance Jio, and the aim being to bring together JioMart, Jio Small Business Initiative, with the power of WhatsApp and enable people to connect the businesses and ultimate purchase products in a seamless mobile experience. Well, I have been a diehard optimist always. The challenges like coronavirus now, or maybe Industry 4 tomorrow, are only a passing phase. The resolute nature of the Indian MSMEs, the exposure of them to the technologies, the synergies with the industry associations and the peers in the industry make Indian MSMEs unstoppable. And with this background, I would like to invite my co-panelist, Mr. Vidyasagar Singh, to share his experiences and share with the Indian MSMEs who are already there and people who believe that e-marketing could be the best option today and in the times to come tomorrow. I hand it over to Mr. Vidyasagar Singh.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. First of all, I would like to thanks Dr. Gulshan Sharma and ICSI for giving me this opportunity on a topic which is very, very close to my heart and I'm very passionate about, which is leveraging e-commerce for MSMEs growth. So I think Ravindranath sir have already set the background and he have talked about, you know, how e-commerce industry is moving, how it can benefit MSMEs. I will just give a very, very basic sense of, you know, what e-commerce can do and why MSME should go, you know, and latch on. So it is very simple. As you mentioned that, you know, there is some, you know, shop in Chandni Chowk, B2B, for example. But any retail store or any brand or any manufacturer, this physical reach is always a limitation. There are great artisans, there are great manufacturers who have been producing world-class product. They are very good in product development and very good in manufacturing. But, you know, probably, you know, next town in next villages, nobody knows about them. They are only known to the local market or a local catchment. But they, and this is a problem for their growth. This is inhibiting their growth. And this is the marketing challenge, you know, most of the Indian MSMEs are facing, frankly speaking. So here the e-commerce, you know, gives the solution. So this e-commerce, you know, you do not have any boundaries in terms of, you know, local or national or international. Frankly speaking, this e-commerce have made something which, you know, we used to read global village, or even we see Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam in Sanskrit. So this e-commerce, you know, have made it really a global village, because with this cross-border e-commerce opportunities, you know, provided by many marketplaces and even many service providers who are facilitating, you know, that journey through that lot of impanel service provider, is truly making it a global village, and they are breaking the boundaries. There are cross-border e-commerce, there are B2B, B2C already happening, you know, from India to other countries. And this Indian products like Ayurveda, handicraft, jewelries, you know, all those products are reaching to the world at a much, much better price than what they can afford in Indian market, you know, that what Indian market can afford to pay them. So I think this sets the background that, you know, sidhi si baat hai, jo dikhta hai, wo bikta hai. So offline market, may, you know, you will always have a limited reach, limited visibility and limited discoverability of your product, or even for that matter, your brand, or, you know, your company or your capacities. Whereas e-commerce give you the unlimited visibility and discoverability through the technology, which is e-commerce. And the best part is that e-commerce is for everyone. Nobody can say, nahi, nahi, mera product ya my product is not relevant, or I'm, you know, producing for, you know, such kind of customers. So there are the best part is e-commerce is for everyone. There are multiple platform, multiple kind of service provider, specialty store. So horizontal marketplaces, vertical marketplaces, B2B, B2C, C2C, even B2G. So these are the multiple, you know, platform which are giving opportunity to everyone, whether you are a manufacturer, you are service provider, you are trader, you are irrespective of category you are into, whatever you are producing. Just, you know, if we see that, you know, our Prime Minister have been emphasizing so much, you know, even during his first instant, he have mentioned about his constituency Varanasi, that, you know, Banaras ki silk sarees, they can reach out to the whole world through e-commerce, and there are a lot of work is already happening. Same applies for, you know, whether Rajasthani handicraft or, you know, Kanpur leather products, they can fetch much, much better price, you know, through e-commerce media, you know, to the world. Now I will talk about that. Why? What are the key benefits? Why MSME should, you know, go on e-commerce? So I'll start from this COVID period, which is, you know, pre-COVID and post-COVID. Now, you know, we have started using this word. So many of the companies or brand are even, you know, in NSIC, we have seen that the portfolios which are online, you know, have even despite of this lockdown and, you know, businesses being closed, have grown as compared to the same period last year. It is real and it is happening. And there are many people who are experiencing this. So, and who are not online are missing this opportunity. They are struggling. But there are still opportunity for everyone to join and, you know, grow their business. If we talk about Indian e-commerce business, which is growing the fastest in the world, if we take, you know, the figure of, you know, 2019, it have grown almost by 32%. And the reason is that, you know, the internet boom, you know, data boom, you know, with almost 500 million internet users, you know, there is an opportunity for everyone. As we know that, you know, data is probably the cheapest in the world in India. So that's helping us, you know, boom the Indian e-commerce. Ravindranath have already mentioned, but still I would like to emphasize that, you know, if any brand or any manufacturer want to expand his market, he can do it as much, much lesser cost as compared to offline. Of course, you know, I mean, no, you know, there is nothing to think. I mean, there is no mention of that, you know, you can increase your reach and, you know, access national or geographical, but the cost is very, very low. Apart from that, you know, the best part, e-commerce is not just only a retail, you know, another platform, but it's a brand building platform, I would say. You know, you can improve your brand experience, you can improve your customer experience, and the best part is you can get a lot of insights and data. What is the trend? What is the demand? How people are reacting? What is required? Who are your competitors? How they are selling? What are the pricing? All these, you know, information can be leveraged to price your product better, develop new product, maybe develop new variants, develop, you know, target a specific customer base who are looking for those product category. All these is possible through e-commerce. If we say that, you know, so if we see that all those marketplaces, whether, you know, the big player, whether it's Amazon, Alibaba, Flipkart, or, you know, for that matter, almost all the big e-commerce player have focusing on Indian MSMEs. There are separate team who are managing. There are separate platform. There are separate links to promote them. There are separate packages. And this is up to the MSME to join and, you know, benefit. There are multiple. You must all be seeing that, you know, in the newspaper, the Economic Times and everywhere, you know, Amazon is focusing so much. There was a big program in Delhi, you know, with lakhs of MSMEs were invited to join. There is something called Amazon Karigar, you know, many, many such programs. If we talk about government side, so a lot have happened in government to promote the e-commerce. The new e-commerce policy is in making, which is, you know, focusing on MSME and, you know, trying to protect their interest, giving them, you know, everyone equal opportunity. Within government, the government have, you know, GEM. If we talk about government procurement, lot have changed. Now you don't, you know, any MSME who is interested in government procurement don't need to visit a lot of government offices trying to, you know, get, you know, order from them. They don't need to get with the cumbersome process, you know, of visiting, you know, doing a lot of formalities, paperwork, you know, all those. Everything is so transparent thanks to government policies through GeM, government e-marketplace, which is, you know, and, you know, we know in India, the government is the biggest buyer in India with some $1 trillion, you know, buying annually. So the MSMEs who are interested in supplying to government must onboard on GeM, government e-marketplace, if it's, you know, they have not already onboarded. And, you know, you must be knowing that, you know, GeM have already closed more than 40,000 crore turnover, you know, last year. And they're expanding, they're adding more and more new categories. So even if your category is not there, still you can, you know, register, and every day new category is being added. Orders are automatically coming to your inbox. You know, there is a payments are automatic without any delay. You don't have to, you know, follow up. So that is the best part of the technology and e-commerce. There are, if we also talk about, there are specific, you know, segment like, you know, TriFed. TriFed is running a portal called Tribes India. So to help, you know, tribal products, you know, reach international market, you know, get the right value, Tribes India portal is there. And if, you know, you are from this tribal community anywhere in India, you know, you can onboard this portal, you can join Tribes India, and you can get benefited, you know, unlimited reach and, you know, all the benefits. So the best part of this e-commerce is that, you know, it is very, very simple. You don't have to be really, really tech savvy, or you don't have to, because you, what you have to do is you have to just, you know, register. And all the e-commerce players have already impaneled all kind of service provider, whether it is a photography, cataloging, account management, pricing, digital marketing, SEO marketing, SEO, you know, management, everything, there are impaneled service provider. So what you have to do is you can just register, you focus on what you are great into. So if you are great into manufacturing certain product ad category, you just focus on that and let the, you know, experts manage your marketing part. E-commerce service provider or e-commerce companies manage, you know, your part. All said and done, but no doubt that, you know, e-commerce is growing. But if we see the Indian MSME, which is almost, you know, 60 million, the number. But if we see the active seller on marketplaces, the numbers are still not too big. And where, you know, here there is opportunity. Here there is opportunity. Here there is a kind of, you know, hand-holding role, or the role of, for each stakeholder to bring more and more MSMEs on board, so that, you know, they, especially the bottom of the pyramid, you know, the, especially the micro units, artisan units, they need to be onboarded somehow. So they are left out. Otherwise, if they don't grow, this cannot be called inclusive growth, or this cannot be called, you know, that e-commerce is doing very good to the economy, or, you know, and that's here, there is, that's why there is a certain discomfort among certain MSMEs or certain trading community, and they feel that it is not helping them. So why I have been thinking that, why, what is the problem? So, or what is the probable solution? So I feel that, you know, solution is not in just in making, you know, a few more portals, because portals already exist, and there are specialty portal, there are, I mean, they have reach, and they, you know, there is a you know, lot of system is already placed. But the problem is that these micro units are, these artisans are not, you know, technically qualified, or they don't know how to get benefited from this marketplace, these marketplaces are this e-commerce boom. So my suggestion would be that, you know, although there is a lot of work is happening, but all these stakeholders, whether it is industry associations, chambers, regulatory bodies or marketplaces, they have to come together and, you know, probably do some kind of, you know, training activities, or even that, you know, Digital India or Digital MSME scheme, or, you know, Skill India scheme of the government can be used. So, you know, to help these people. What I feel is that, you know, this e-commerce, you know, we need to train youth on e-commerce account management or account e-commerce business management. And if we focus it on the cluster-wise or certain, because e-commerce, I mean, every category is important, you know, and every category have its own nuances. If I talk about apparel, if I talk about, you know, handicraft, if I talk about general merchandise, if I talk about industrial goods, so the person needs to understand the category So if we somehow can develop some module on e-commerce business management under Skill India development, and if we can create some e-commerce champions, I would say, in each clusters, and I think it would be win-win situation, because this youth will get, you know, job opportunity. These entrepreneurs or manufacturers who are missing this e-commerce, you know, the boom, will be getting the skilled manpower to manage their business, which otherwise they are not able to do. As of now, this is the problem, that, you know, they don't have reliable, credible experts, you know, to whom they can hire or to whom they can give this portfolio, and they, you know, just they can rely upon. So if we can have develop some of this, you know, e-commerce champions in each cluster category wise, this can, you know, solve both the problem, and it would be probably win for all of us, you know, win for you know, this youth, win for manufacturer, win for marketplaces, and win for government and country, because economy is going to take, I mean, it will leapfrog, frankly speaking, the kind of potential e-commerce provide. If once they come on the e-commerce platform through these e-commerce champions, you know, they will, there is no looking back. You know, we have already experienced in many cases. We have experienced that there are many brand manufacturers who are online brand only. You know, my colleague, you know, from Amrinder ji would throw more light on this. I have seen in my experience in my earlier companies, there are people who started, you know, who registered their brand or label, started online, and they have become so big, and later they expanded to offline market. There is no need to invest in those capex and, you know, stores, rentals, and all those. You can just, you know, start small and become really big. There are hundreds of such examples every day. Why this, I was talking about this e-commerce champions is because e-commerce is a little technical, not that, I mean, technical, but still little technical to be managed. A professional cataloging, you know, understanding of little bit of digital marketing, understanding of keyword which, in, you know, influence your search on the e-commerce portal, you know, quality standardization, packaging. I'll just give you one example. I was just, you know, browsing one of the e-commerce portal, you know, very, very famous e-commerce portal. And I saw there is a seller from Kerala who is selling some, you know, Ayurvedic product. Reviews and description and everything is very good, you know, but his product picture is in, you know, local language. So here I am sitting in Delhi. Unfortunately, you know, he doesn't understand that e-commerce is giving visibility to his product globally, and unless it is in bilingual language, or it is, you know, I mean people will be struggling, and they may not have the, you know, confidence to buy that product, you know, by reading that they may not be able to understand the description or product. So here is a challenge. So these are small things which is, you know, inhibiting their growth, and, you know, the same sale may not be good. Small things like, you know, I also noticed that, you know, there are some sellers who list their product as, you know, non-returnable, which is again a problem. They need to be told that, you know, by making it non-returnable, they are just returning 80% of the customer. They will not buy. And it's so easy. They don't have to do all those logistics. The logistics part is already taken care by marketplaces, and they don't have to worry about it. Everything is managed. That's why I was saying that it's a little technical, and we need experts, and, you know, youth, you know, today's youth who are already, you know, tech savvy on internet, everybody is on a smartphone, they can be trained to develop this market. And like something like cluster, like UP government ODOP can be great. One district, one, you know, product is a great idea to develop champions, the e-commerce champion related to a specific product. So there is no, I mean, it is very, very easy, and all of us understand. We have all seen, if we have been reading the newspaper, that, you know, all those the companies who have been leveraging e-commerce are growing even after COVID. Who have not been there, they are missing. With this, I would also like to talk about NSIC initiative, what we have been doing to help MSMEs come online and take advantage of all these portals. So we already have a portal called msmemart.com, which is a B2B portal, business to business portal. Business to business means normally it is, you know, for wholesale businesses, and, you know, the manufacturer can supply to other distributor or other, you know, companies who require their product in bulk. The product can be anything. Product can be industrial, or product can be direct consumable finished product. But the requirement is, if it is in bulk, it is the called B2B portal. So if I can quickly take you through the, just few slides so that you will have the feel of it, then it will be So I hope you know my screen is visible now.
It's visible.
Yeah. Yeah,
great, sir. Thank you. So this is, so here we have a B2B portal called MSME Global Mart. What this portal does is, it is basically, it is a connecting platform. So it connects, you know, buyers and sellers, and it's a matchmaking platform. It, you know, help get visibility and discoverability, what I was mentioning. So we already have more than 1.5 lakh members, you know, across categories, across section. It is already helping a lot of families. And there are people who are, you know, members from more than 10 years on this portal. They have been, since portal is on an annual membership basis, they are very, very, you know, regular, and they have been following it up, you know, to renew their membership because they are benefiting. We have hundreds of numerous success stories through the portal. What this portal does is, the key benefit of the portal are, it increases discoverability. What we were mentioning, that, you know, if you are making a great product, or if you are in any part of the country, anywhere, you know, this portal, through this portal, you can create your own mini company website, and it is, templates are available. It is very, very easy to do. Within minutes, you can create your own company website. You can display your product and services 24/7, 365 days. It is visible. It is why it is more helpful is because, you know, in this, maybe we don't know how many more months there will be no physical events, no physical exhibition. So this is the platform you can join. You can, you know, be part of this internet boom. You can display your product and services to the whole world 24/7, 365 days. You don't need to be physically present. You don't need to be there. You don't need to travel. You don't need to visit those, you know, exhibition centers. Still, you can be visible to the whole world. The portal is, you know, it connects the buyers and supplier, and there are the portal have visitors from across the globe. Of course, the majority is from India, but, you know, if we see that the portal after that, you know, the US is the biggest, you know, the traffic which generates this portal. The best part is, we provide keyword based unlimited tender alerts for MSME. This is basically facilitating public procurement. So as per public procurement order, 25% of procurement from, you know, have to be done from MSME. How we help MSMEs is that, based on their keyword, whatever they are producing or whatever is their service, we provide unlimited tender alerts in the inbox of the MSME. They don't have to visit multiple portal, multiple, you know, newspaper or to find out which, you know, tender is coming, you know, related to them. There are franchisee and distributorship opportunities for the people who are looking to set up a new business, new opportunities. There are requests for quotation tool. You know, if buyer, any buyer who is visiting the portal can, you know, ask for quotation from the multiple supplier, from a specific supplier on a specific product, and it will be responded. Information on events and exhibition have been provided. For the timing, it is not much useful, but, you know, there are trade leads which is being provided. One is, so unique features of the portal is, and the best part, it is available in multiple languages. You know, you name it and this portal is available in that language. You can easily select your language from the top, and, you know, it is available. Some of the benefits to supplier and, you know, buyer is, which is very, very common, which everybody knows what the suppliers are looking for. So all these features are available to the suppliers, and all these features are available to buyers, which is available here. So any MSME who is looking to expand their global reach or expand their visibility and discoverability, as we talked about, can join the portal, you know, by visiting the msmemart.com. It is completely online. You don't need to visit any office. You don't need to fill any form. You can, from your home or from your office, you can just register on the portal, and from the next day, you will start getting the benefit. With these words, I would thank again Dr. Gulshan, and, you know, I would hand over the space to my co-panelist Sri Amrinder ji to talk more specific about, you know, Amazon Global Selling, which he represents, and how MSME can benefit from those marketplace boom and e-commerce boom. Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Shri Vidya ji. Upfront, I'd like to thank Dr. Gulshan ji and Shri Ravindranath ji for giving us the opportunity, another channel to connect with MSMEs here. That has been our focus, has been the backbone of our business since we started here. And Mr. Vidya ji very aptly put the need for e-commerce in these times, and not just in these times, but overall on how we are empowering MSMEs. I think our objective has always been to not let capital considerations allow someone to not succeed. That's where we started in India. And since 2015, we thought that the reach should not be limited by borders as well. So like Mr. Vidyaji very aptly put, for any small store, any shop, you are always limited by the catchment area that you are in. We have thousands of years of history. We know the products. We know the goodness in our products, the talent that we've had. And it's just about making sure that people worldwide are able to have access to those products. So what e-commerce does is two things. One, provide sellers the access to customers, which are not limited by how many stores can you open, how many loans can you take. So step one was that a shopkeeper in Kashmir should be able to sell a product in Kanyakumari to a customer who actually needs it. And that was an extension that we took and then said, why wouldn't a person sitting in a US or a Middle East or an Australia who would need these products, who when come to India are awed by the sheer talent of the products that we provide, be not able to access these things. So basis that we set up in 2015, the Amazon Global Selling Program, the idea was very simple, that every business based out of India, irrespective of the size, even if it's a shop or if it's a big brand, should be able to sell products globally by sitting where they are using just one laptop. They would not need to have to worry about tying up with partners, figuring out on how local regulations work, but they should just have one laptop at home and use their products and make them available globally. So that's where we started in 2015. And I am honored and I'm happy to share we released our next edition of Export Digest some time back. Honorable Minister Nitin Gadkari was there, and we shared the happy news that within such a short span of time, we hit $1 billion in export. And these are all exports from India, majorly driven by our MSMEs. It took about 3 years to hit $1 billion, but the next $1 billion came in almost just a year. So we've now hit $2 billion in exports from India, from people sitting here in India using a laptop, all small and medium, majorly driven by small and medium enterprises who are selling goods to consumers in 15 countries. So that was the vision, and that's where we are happy to share that that vision has been realized. And I think with Corona coming in, one good thing that we've taken and we are so honored to see is the spirit of MSMEs. All our partners, sellers who sell with us, were not discouraged with the new situation that has arisen. What they have done is, what's next? How do we overcome this? And how do we move in a way where it allows us to leverage this situation? I will share a very small example. Given the situation arose across the world, our partners, our sellers in apparel, in textiles, were the first ones to move and identify the new need coming in this sector. Before your bigger brands moved into it, we had our MSMEs making cloth masks and providing it globally. They made sure that the need in India is met. And then they made sure that they have this, since they have the social responsibility, it was not just about making products available and making money for themselves. They realized the social responsibility, the unorganized sector that was being hit with the sales or the revenues going down. How do we make sure those karigars, those talented people continue to work with us? And the only way to do that is to make sure the businesses continue to thrive. So that was one very short example where we were amazed at the spirit and the never die attitude that we saw with small and medium businesses. From our end, what we are trying to do, and Vidyaji also mentioned, we had a huge event called Sambhav, where Jeff had also come to India, where we promised 10 billion investments in technology to empower small and medium businesses. So our idea is clear that we want to empower these businesses, and we want to create an ecosystem where any expertise or any new learning that anyone, a shopkeeper or a small business or a medium business needs, is made available. So while at Amazon we are empowering, we are putting in technology that will not ask everyone to learn a new initiative every single time. For example, if you sell in 15 countries, you sell in Japan, you sell in US, and you are based out of X, you will not have to learn Japanese to launch in Japan. We will use technology to make sure translation happens automatically so that you can focus on the thing that you are really good at, which is making a great product and providing it worldwide. So that was one. So we are using technology to remove those barriers. And the other side is we are getting immense response from our MSMEs by making sure India is on the world map, making sure that we are showcasing our manufacturing capability. So that's just a short, a vision that we have, and we are happy that we are a small part of it. I know we are over time. What I'll do is I'll just take maybe a few minutes. I have a PPT that quickly shares on an actionable with MSMEs who may have joined us on how quickly you can come. You do not need CapEx. You do not need a lot of money. And you can actually go live with us in 2 days in 15 different countries, if that's what it takes, right? So I'll just share my screen quickly and quickly run you through the process. Can you guys see my screen?
Yep.
Yes, yes.
Perfect. So this is what I was talking about. So overall, as per a report that came out, almost 1 trillion worth of goods will be exchanged across in cross-border e-commerce by end of this year. That's how big the opportunity is. And based on a few reports that we've seen, almost 300 billion is being driven by Indian MSMEs who are selling in multiple countries, who are selling in multiple categories. When it comes down to Amazon, the top destinations where we've seen since 2015 sellers becoming successful is US, which is the largest market for Amazon as well. Then you see 4 countries in Europe, EU5, what we see, and you would have seen the recent news that we've launched in Sweden as well. Then Australia, we've had a lot of success stories in Japan. And then we recently last year opened Middle East as well, with UAE launched and Saudi being launched earlier this year. The top categories, if you see, are pretty much the same that you see in offline exports that we've seen. Jewelry has been, when it comes to non-oil exports, jewelry has always been the top export category globally. In most of our trading partners, that's the top category. We do a lot of business in offline exports as well, in apparel, in textiles. Leather is again something we've done well. And we are very happy to see that Ayurveda and Ayurveda-based products are seeing huge traction. And our MSMEs have helped set up these trends. You now go to a Starbucks, you can get a turmeric latte, something which for thousands of years in India has been a known powerhouse immunity booster for us. So that's really good to see, and we are seeing that across. All of this comes down to the vision that our Honorable Prime Minister had shared, that we want to build global brands, which have been at one point local. So we are starting from there. One, we are helping these small businesses build their brands, and then we are helping them to become global and not just in India. Honorable Minister Shri Nitin Gadkariji, like I was saying, we released our Export Digest recently, and he has been very focused, very vocal about making sure that our MSMEs succeed, not just within India, but globally. And that's what we are working towards. And Jeff, like I said, under that vision has made sure that we invest enough in technology to make sure that these MSMEs succeed. Talking about the global selling from where I come from, like I said, in 2015, when we started with a few thousand sellers and just few million products, have grown into a huge business. Since 2015, we have more than 50,000 plus active sellers selling with us in all these marketplaces, the 15 marketplaces that I talked about. And there are more than 140 million products available from India. And this includes everything from sellers selling sarees to sellers, customers in US, in Sweden, in UK. And since then, we have grown 100%. Like I said, it took us 3 years to hit the first 1 billion. And it has taken us just under 1 year, or just about 1 year, to hit 2 billion. And we've already working towards the vision where we want to increase this numbers to a number to 10 billion by 2025. So that's where we are working towards. And hence, we want more and more technology to be in place where we can enable more MSMEs to come through. This again, just a quick view of where Amazon operates. We currently offer 15 marketplaces that these MSMEs can target, can immediately opt into. And the biggest blocker that we saw was always, how do I ship my products? How do I make sure my products reach this? So we have 250 million square feet of global fulfillment solutions that we provide. So the idea should be, you should again only have a laptop at home, and everything else should be taken care of by us in selling those. In terms of how this process works, it's just three simple steps that it takes. If you are an MSME, you have your Make in India product. You take that product and you register with us on Amazon Global Selling. It takes only about 1 to 2 days to get that process done. Then you ship your products to our fulfillment center, which are basically warehouses that we have in different countries. You just ship in one go in whatever quantities, whatever number you feel comfortable with. And post that, we take complete responsibility of doing everything on your behalf. Your customer care, for example, you set out, let's say, 5 units to our warehouse in Alabama. But if a order comes from Alaska, it's our responsibility to make sure that that product reaches that customer within 1 day, if you're a prime customer, right? So our fulfillment centers take care of, if it's expensive items, they need requirements, they need sensitive handling. Our warehouses are equipped to make sure your products are not mishandled there. Most of our marketplaces also allow customers globally. So while we are present in 15 marketplaces, customers from over 180 countries shop at these marketplaces. So a person sitting in, let's say, Jordan will go on Amazon.com and place an order. So while you might only be available in 15 marketplaces, but your reach is global. So any country where we can ship products, we will ship it. They can come on our websites and they place that order. And that's a huge business that we see coming across. And the last bit is that we are able to, our MSMEs are able to receive these payments in INR. So you don't need to worry about setting up bank accounts in marketplaces in any new market that you go to. So we are able to give your money in INR that you can then put back into your business quickly at a regular cadence. This is again what we've already talked about, warehouse logistics. I think the last part is important. That's the vision as well, that CapEx should not force anyone to not be able to scale their business. It's pure OPEX. how many products can you make, how many products can you make them available in how many marketplace, and that's all. You don't need to set up warehouses there. You don't need to tie up with banks there to figure out how this works. And more importantly, you don't have to, let's say Diwali is the biggest season that we have when most of our sales happen. We have Black Friday in US, which is their Diwali equivalent, which is the biggest shopping season, Thanksgiving, White Friday in Middle East, Prime Day, which is across the board. So what we are trying to do is you start in January, each month you will have one big business. So you see your 10x, 50x, 100x jump in sales, not just during a small 2 week window, but throughout the year. Like every month you should have it. And the worry you should have is, are we able to keep up with the demand that's coming in? And not that, hey, we are not able to sell our products. These are some of the examples, some of our success stories that we've seen since 2015. All of these guys were either B2B players, SMEs who were making it for other brands who would charge a 50x premium on it probably and sell it to consumers. This is a win-win for both our sellers and customers. Our sellers are no longer responsible, are no longer dependent on in-between parties, traders, you know, third parties, these big brands who have stores to be successful. These MSMEs, what we also realized, have the right products, have the right quality. The only thing that they don't have is the reach. And the moment we enable that, we've seen these success stories coming up. And as you can see, these are all big categories, you know, where we are huge in B2B. If you go to Ministry of Commerce and see the top export categories, B2B, all of these will feature there. And now all of these are brands that are selling directly. So B2C, the gap that was there is being bridged. And like I said, it's a moment of honor for all of us is when we see huge, you know, demand coming in our traditional categories like Ayurveda. You know, we've seen a lot of these innovation with startups that we've seen. If it comes to toys, India has always been known as the country that provides, you know, since Aryabhatta, the one that's really good in education, like the vision that we are envisioning right now. So a lot of these toys brand that you see, Skillmatic, Jack in the Box, these are all unique toys which are grounded in education. Like how do you educate your 5-year-olds, 10-year-olds to do better? How can they learn math in a fun way? How can they learn science in a fun way? Right? So these were there. Quickly moving on to how do you start. The process, like I said, is 3 steps. You fill in your basic details with your payment information, your bank account. You list the details of the product you want to sell. You add your pictures. If you have a sari, you take your pictures that best showcase your product. You put your title that says Banarsi Sari XYZ X year old. And what details they have and what's your unique selling point. And you just use this delivery option. And in 2 days, you can be live in US. You can live in UK, in Australia, in Singapore. The only things that you need are these four. You need to have one email ID. You need to have a valid business address from your place of operation. You need to have one credit card where international transactions are enabled. While we have the technology to provide the money in your bank account directly in INR, given the buying happens and the government guidelines that are here, you just need one credit card where it can be charged. And then in some countries, for example, in Europe, in Middle East, in UAE, Saudi, the destination markets ask that you have a VAT number, similar to what you guys are used to. But again, these are very destination specific. For example, you might not need a VAT in any other marketplaces. This is just one of the, like you said, this was a MSME with us in a B2B space. He now, if you see the listing, is so robust, so detailed out, where they are fully able to communicate to the end consumers the value that they bring in. And the pricing, which is probably 1/3 of what these customers get in their offline stores or elsewhere via other brands. The checklist is very simple. We have educational videos on YouTube that quickly run you through all of this. But broadly, if you understand this once, I think you already have all the knowledge with one laptop at your home. listings like how Mr. Vidyaji also mentioned in his Kerala example that I'm sitting in Delhi and I'm not able to figure that out. We again are using technology to not have that problem come in globally. So if we go to Japan, that you wouldn't need to learn Japanese to do that. The technology should automatically translate that so that the local consumers can buy. Same goes for German, French, so on and so forth. And that's what we are doing as new marketplaces come up. Like Middle East is the new destination we've added. So there's an automatic translation in Arabic that can happen given it's such a huge market for us. In terms of fulfillment, again, I think that was one area that has always been the most problematic. So we have that, like I said before, we have warehouses everywhere. However, if you don't even want to tie in your capex anywhere and send some products which are then tied in, you can actually just send those products out to end consumer whenever an order comes in, which is called individual carriers, what you see here. And we are putting investments in place that that typically, again, coming down to the same part, you only need a laptop at home. We will provide door-to-door pickup. If an order comes in from US, someone will come to your door, pick it up, take the export documentation with you, educate you on what is needed, and then deliver it to the end consumers as well. And the best part of this is that irrespective of where you are, if we promise our customer a two-day delivery, if you are with us in Prime, you still, if you are an Indian seller, your product still reaches our end customer in US, in Japan, in UK within 2 days. And the last is what we said, like it's very easy to start. You can start in 15 marketplaces in a couple of days. You just upload your listings and you can get started. And we hope this is a small contribution we are able to make in these times for any businesses who have been hit because of physical stores. So please come. Please open up your great products that will have a huge demand with us globally. And we are happy to contribute in whatever way we can. All right. Thank you. That's about it briefly from my side.
Well, thank you, Amrinder ji, and thank you, Vidyasagar. There have been very enriching talks given by both of you, and I'm sure the MSME fraternity looking at your presentations, hearing you both in India as well as in abroad, would definitely be saying one thing. The one word which comes to my mind is, wow, the opportunities are tremendous. Challenges like pandemic, like corona, challenges like economy is taking a downturn, they're all temporary. But what really sustains and what really survives is the opportunity which you are providing. No capex, only opex. Don't tell me that there is no demand. Tell me how much can you produce, the quality you can produce. And I'm sure with all this, what we have shared with the MSMEs, they would be definitely taking up all these stuff forward and snatching this as an opportunity. That even because what good thing which has happened, even if corona has struck, the buildings are intact, the machinery is intact, the labor might have gone away for some time, they will definitely come back. The demand is very much there. I was reminded of what amongst the five pillars which our Prime Minister mentioned, and demand was one of them. The huge demand within India, the huge demand outside India, the opportunities which are coming up for the Indian MSMEs. The Atmanirbhar Bharat cannot happen without Indian MSMEs being there. And players like Amazon, players like NSIC, players like others who are there, they are all giving solutions and assuring that, well, focus on one thing, focus on your production, focus on your qualities, and the world is before you. I have very often during the course of my service with NSIC got opportunities to interact with people world over. And one thing which really made me swell with pride was everybody wanted to engage with Indian MSMEs. And that is corroborated by what you just mentioned. If the jump in your business from 1 billion to 2 billion and what is being looked up by a company like Amazon, if you look at the overall figures which are being projected for India, Indian MSMEs, these are all opportunities. And technology innovations in areas of digital payments, technology innovations in areas of hyperlocal logistics, in areas of digital advertisements, where you don't have to worry about anything. You don't have to bother about ki main store kahan karunga saman. Jaise aap bata rahe the ki US mein agar usko products bhejne hain, Japan mein bhejne hain, he doesn't have to bother about how the storage will happen, who will take care of all that stuff. He has only to tell how much can he manufacture, the quality has to be assured, and definitely the opportunities are all in front of them. And if there are people who really need to synergize at this juncture to make e-commerce a big success for them as SMEs, I would say it is the industry associations. They have all to rally behind each other. They have all to stand behind each other and say, well, दिक्कत आई है, प्रॉब्लम आई है, कोई बात नहीं, इसको भी फेस करेंगे. ये कोई पहली बार तो इंडियन एमएसएमईज के साथ हुआ नहीं है. दूसरा, द ई-कॉमर्स प्लेयर्स एंड एस्पेशली द वेरी इनकरेजिंग फिगर्स विच अमरिंदर जी यू जस्ट मेंशन, आई एम श्योर दिस वुड बी म्यूजिक टू द एयर्स ऑफ वेरियस एमएसएमईज एंड विद अदर प्लेयर्स कमिंग इन. एज आई जस्ट मेंशन, इफ जियो मार्ट इज गोइंग टू कम अप इन सच अ बिग वे, if SBI is going to come up in such a big way, dovetail the marketing with the finances, or even HDFC also coming up in a big way, and several other players who are already there, these are opportunities, and more the merrier, as they say, and opportunities for the MSMEs to pick the best who renders the best service to them. And also, as Mr. Vidyasagar also mentioned, the regulatory bodies, the government coming out with various policies which would be supporting this thing, supporting e-commerce in our country. And at the end of the day, what comes up is, it not only promotes business for the Indian MSMEs, it promotes employment. I was listening to Mr. Vidyasagar, how simple the whole thing has been. And as you repeatedly mentioned, one thing which you repeatedly mentioned was you need to have a laptop. Baaki cheezon ki chinta nahi kariye, samaan banaiye, apna uske upar daliye aur bechiye. So have that aptitude to sell, have that aptitude to manufacture. And in the process, what are you creating? You're creating employment for the huge, huge numbers of educated youth in our country. You're creating revenues from exports, you're creating revenues from internal marketings, which in turn add up to the revenues which go to the exchequer. All this is basically signs of a booming economy. It might be a dip for the time being, Dr. Gulshan Sharma. This is what I believe would be the conclusion coming out of our today's program. But if I link it with the story which I mentioned at the beginning, if you are able to adapt to change, I'm sure the world is right in front of us. And e-commerce is one of the best alternatives available. We don't say that the traditional methods of selling will disappear. The ladies going and feeling that sari in a sari store would vanish. But there are opportunities which are available more than the traditional methods of selling which were so far there. As Vidyasagar rightly said, if we confine ourselves to offline, we would be only restricting ourselves to the area where we are selling. But if we go online and if we take technology as a mode of selling, the entire world knows us. And India is a land of not only plenty of opportunities, but diverse products which are there. And agar ek time pe puri duniya के साथ ट्रेड होती थी, ई-कॉमर्स provides us that opportunity to again recreate that world where probably we were the world beaters when it came to trade. And why not? If today requires nutrition diets, and well, I never heard somebody asking for a healthy coffee. But then Corona makes us drink healthy more often than we probably ever thought. And the best healthy, wherever it is made in India, it provides an opportunity for those people to sell it globally and get the best prices. So it provides an opportunity which is a win-win situation for everyone, be it the farmers, be it the MSMEs in the general industry, or the industrial MSMEs, the agriculture MSMEs, or maybe from any area where we would like to pick up. E-commerce opens the doors for India to reach out to the world and the world to reach out to MSMEs. Well, with these words, I once again thank Mr. Vidyasagar Singh and Mr. Amrinder Singh Chahal for your valuable inputs, your time which you could spare today for this program. And also on behalf of all three of us, I would like to thank Dr. Gulshan Sharma for allowing ICI to provide us this opportunity to share these views with the Indian MSMEs. And I'm sure people would have been benefited. We would be prepared to come back again with some specific topics which can be taken even with respect to e-commerce. But for the time being, thank you very much. And once again, thanks to Dr. Gulshan Sharma for this opportunity which you gave us.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. I run short of words. Nothing could have been more or a better beginning than to talk with the e-commerce when we are talking about technology, we are talking about innovation, we are talking about networking, when we are talking about going global. It's a wonderful beginning with the new education policy. And I was just trying to gather from all three of you that when we mentioned about the part-time or the internship and school and college youth getting an opportunity, they would be in a position to get some pocket money that Vidyasagar ji was telling. And Amrinder ji made everything, I do not know, but I personally feel he made me feel so simple that getting with the Amazon is just a little away and a few steps and you can be a part of it.
Absolutely.
And, India should maintain quality and we all should try and do the best possible. And those of us, those are facing challenges, we will start the process. Today is a humble beginning, what we have taken up. Many more things are there. A lot of questions have come. We will take it up next time. We look forward to yet another powerful evening. And every Sunday evening will be dedicated to MSME. And this being the final program in the evening, because it suits people in Canada, it suits people in America, and it also suits people in Latin America and European. So I've taken the consent of everybody that how to go by and which way to go by and what time is to be taken. And people, those are in the Middle East, they are also very happy because a lot of people have gone from Kerala and down south to Middle East, and those are working over there. So they're very comfortable. They're very happy onto that. Middle East, the Central Asia is also emerging in a very big way. And now, of course, this is a sleep time, just about to sleep as far as ASEAN is concerned. So time is no limit. And next week onward, that is, we will take few questions which have come. We will answer them from the next week and we will take it up. With these words, my deepest regards and thanks. I personally feel now I'm in a safe hands. Ravindranath ji will take this beautiful journey of the MSME the best possible way. And my gratitudes to Vidyasagar ji and Amrinder ji. It was a wonderful information for me as well. In between, you might have seen sometime I was looking down because more than 4,000 hits are there on the watch party and my different accounts which are coming from the world over. So I got to satisfy everybody because it's a global platform. With these words, ladies and gentlemen, thanks for joining us this evening. Thanks for being with us. and a wonderful journey of the MSME starts today. And from here, every Sunday, 7 p.m., under the dynamic and dedicated leadership of Rabindranathji, we look forward to yet another beautiful Sunday evening. Those of us, those are interested to do something in ASEAN and India, tomorrow morning, there is a medical tourism at 8:45 a.m. Indian Standard Time, where we are going to have the doctor basically discussing the business and the kind of medical treatment between India and ASEAN, 8:45 a.m. God bless all of us. Thanks for joining. Thank you very much. Good morning and good afternoon and good evening and green morning and green afternoon and green evening.